Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I want to give a little bit of a quick rundown, I guess, into the options for explicitly ignoring the return value from a function. We've got underscore, standard ignore, and maybe unused. To get standard ignore, I believe we need the tuple header. We're going to create some undefined function. That is called get value. We don't really care about that, but we want to explicitly make sure this thing is no discard. And I just realized, let's go ahead and return a pair of ints because that'll make this considerably more interesting. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains, and I wanted to let you know that I do personally use CLion in my work. I find the refactoring tools to be particularly valuable. The safe delete feature has saved me a ton of time when I've been doing refactoring on large projects. I can get analysis of my compile time checks and see when something is wrong or fails to compile right here in my IDE. So be sure to check out the links in the video description for a discount code and more information about how you can check out CLion. Okay. Say I call get value. This is going to be a warning, and with my configuration, a warning treated as an error because I'm ignoring the value from a function that was marked no discard. There we go. I can do something like this. Now I'm going to have an unused variable warning. I can mark this variable as maybe unused attribute. Now I will no longer get that warning from the compiler, and I have successfully ignored the return value from a function, if that is really what I wanted to do. I've never personally used this in real code. Is this standard ignore thing? And this is an object that is assignable to from anything, and it just kind of makes the value go away. It's going to be very interesting to turn off optimization and see what this actually looks like. So it has to load a pointer to some sort of global object that is the standard ignore object and has the swallow assign thing, which is an assignment that does absolutely nothing. But in the case of a debug build, it still has to actually emit the code to do this. We have one more option, and that is the one from C++ 26, where we can do this explicitly unnamed thing. I'm just giving it an underscore. And the compiler is successfully ignoring this thing. It doesn't make the object go away, though. This underscore still has normal lexical scoping. Its lifetime begins here and it ends here as main is exiting. Just so we know. So those are the three options. They are fairly equal, although standard ignore is going to have more compile time overhead and potentially more runtime overhead. So the underscore, C++ 26 feature, which means you probably can't use it today. Ignore, I believe, is C++ 11. Yes, it is C++ 11, but not constexpr until C++ 14. And maybe unused is a C++ 17 feature. Let us go ahead and do a structured binding here. We want to decompose this thing into its two values. I have this error warning treated as an error again. Structured binding declaration set but not used. Now that's fair. Let's go ahead and use part of it. This depends a lot on your compiler version. If you go back to a fairly old compiler, then you might get a warning that B is unused in this case, but all the modern compilers only warn you if all of the identifiers are unused, as we just saw. Let's say I want to do this. I can maybe mark the entire structured binding as maybe unused. That's weird because that's probably not what I intended to do. I really only wanted to ignore B. I could, well, no, with structured bindings, I really can't ignore only part of it. So The underscore is the only feature that is going to let us explicitly do something like this and say, I want to ignore some portion of this thing and use some other portion of it. Again, a C++ 26 feature. This is weird because I do actually have two completely different objects that are both named underscore, and they both have their lifetime begin on line 17, and they both have their lifetime end on line 19. This is really where the underscore feature shines. I kind of feel like this should probably be our default. Let's go ahead and break down each of the features here. There you have it. C++ 11 introduced standard ignore. You cannot ignore only part of the thing, and the return value is destroyed immediately. This is kind of the moral equivalent of casting to void. Might have compile time and debug time overhead. Maybe unused as an attribute added in C++ 17. You cannot ignore only part, so it doesn't work well structured bindings as well. You must give it a meaningful name, because name clashes on ignored values is just annoying. Return value lives for the rest of the scope, because you've given this thing a name. The underscore option was added in C++ 26. You can ignore only part. This thing is great for structured bindings. You have the weirdness that you've got multiple unreachable variables with the same name, but the return value lives for the rest of the scope as well. But that's going to be true of anything with structured bindings anyhow. It's not possible to destroy only part of a structured binding. Well, there you have it. I hope this was an interesting and informative episode. Be sure to subscribe. I'll catch you later.